manager. Stay with me. Dave!
What's your, what,
how's it going?
It's going well. We're getting set up is way under control. So.
Yay!
What's your favorite of the fourth nuclear reactor designs? I couldn't think of a better question.
I know.
What do you want me to
choose if your starter Pokemon?
What game?
I mean, if you go general type here.
I don't know.
What is your opinion on red panties?
They're super cute.
What's the speed velocity of the swallow?
8 meters per second.
Seems
fast, actually. You actually
8.2 meters per second.
They're apples.
They're apples.
Why did you say, uh-oh?
Are we already out of control already?
Uh-oh.
Have you started for
it?
No, stay
uh-oh.
The show hasn't started yet.
You're lucky that green coat has
teeth. Roro, fight the powers.
That's PRD, by the way, in case you were not aware. Kristen Lindsay, she's the boss of all forces.
Boss of all of you.
If you ever have something that is a problem and you need to escalate to the top of that, that would be worse. That's probably good enough. I am Becker or Beaker or Eric. I answered all of them. I used to be Becker or Beaker only, and now I'm Eric also. I work for Penny Arcade. I have worked every PAX since 07, but in November I got hired by Penny Arcade, so now I actually work for them, and not enforcement, which is PAX I, but that's okay. What else? Everyone here? Probably not. I should be gone. I'm not used. Usually my tours are smaller. I use my outdoor boy. So we're going to do a tour that takes about hour 15, probably. If you need to bail early, that's fine. If you have a meeting or something at 5 or whatever. We're going to start inside here, and then we're going to go out and do the rest of the, some of the rest of the convention center. We're not going to go to the West End, and we're not going to go to the Benaroya. Those are far away. I don't want 2 hours. Or 3 hour tour, that'd be interesting.
3 hour tour. Come on, everybody. Look lively. There we go. Here.
Hey.
How's it going?
It's pretty great.
What you doing?
I'm just leading the tour.
A tour?
Yeah.
What kind of tour?
A tour for the new enforcers.
New enforcers?
Yeah.
New enforcers?
Yay!
So what do you guys do?
Enforce. Whatever you tell us to do.
Have fun.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Anyway, this is what is often called the waterfall escalators right here. is probably the main entrance into PAX, these glass doors. There are several other entrances, but this is probably the main entrance. As you're probably aware, maybe, tomorrow morning, queuing procedure is going to be interesting. We're going to try something new. We don't have a queue hall. There's a multi-stage plan. Basically, people will show up down there at the street level, and the green-coated, olive-coated people, guards, staff, will guide people towards the current queuing location. We're going to start queuing out there. When that's full, there's a secondary spot. When that's full, there's a third spot. I think it goes up to four or five spots, but...
we're hoping we don't have to go that far.
We'll see. But yeah. We're prepared. So anyway, so there is a plan, and it will be a work in progress. It might be tweaked for Saturday. We'll see. Okay, so info booth is there. You've all been there now because you all have your badge. Right? Everyone's got their badge. You need your badge for the tour. So if you don't have your badge, go get your badge real quick. The info is also lost and found. It is, if you have an attendee or some issue and you don't know who to go to solve, talk to your managers or whatever, or you don't have a manager or they're nowhere near you, you can always send them to info. Info is a good place to send anyone that's sort of the buck stops your spot. They have a lot of resources. They know how to contact pretty much anyone at the show as far as staff-wise. So they can solve pretty much any problem from info. So security will also be usually by info, sometimes behind, sometimes in front, in their PRs. And that is info. All right. We are going to go this way towards merch.
So what's your info?
Great. Yeah, I know. I went back to work. That's right.
What about you, man? Well,
hold on.
Oh, yeah.
I have a system.
Alright, so this is the atrium lobby. Sometimes used to be called the south lobby. But now it's the atrium lobby, that's all Frank says. Hall 4B, part of Expo. Hall 4A, used to be Q, now part of Expo. The first aid station in this area is immediately behind you, underneath the escalator there. During show hours, there will always be paramedics there, so send anyone there. You can also call on the house phone, 5187. The red phones will just dial automatically, you just pick them up. That'll get you right to security. Any sort of security issue you have, treat it as 911, effectively. There is also a number on, actually everyone has a sheet of paper that you picked up at registration. That's got the security number on it, something, 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 5187. Forget. So you can punch that in your cell phone. 5127, oh, I had it wrong.
No.
5127, apologies. Anyway, 6-5-4. Anyway, I would recommend putting that in your phone because you can call it from wherever. And you'll just need to make sure that you know where you are in terms of their building. So like, I'm outside Hall 4B or whatever. And they can send paramedics to wherever you are. There's more paramedics on site than just that room. There's several other stations here, so they will get there quickly. Yeah?
Does that apply to the offsite location?
It doesn't apply to the offsite. There's some information on the paper for the various offsites. At least the Sheraton has some information. I think most of the other ones, you would just call 911. Or get the people that are working there and they can it is a good thing, if you're working in an off-site location, ask your managers, deputies, what should we do if this happens? You have some emergency. Because it'll vary based on just like seven locations now. Main merch is there. Everything will be for sale there except for the Edition Polygon, Washington, only get merch light and security. But everything else should be there. And all the stuff at tier will also be merch light.
This
name, I think. That's fine. It'll have less of all the things. Or be smaller. Coming. I don't know. What else? Any questions about this lobby area? Alright, you can peek in there. We don't go into the expo hall because we don't go to the expo hall during setup unless we're working in the expo hall. So that's why we're not going in there. Plus the kitchen. Medical atrium. We have no queue room. I talked about that. Upstairs. All right, we're gonna go back this way and then up the escalator.
So I was like, oh.
So CFP, all the console areas are over there. Classic console, especially over here. I don't know. Well, yeah. So I think it's on this side.
Yeah.
But classic arcade and tourney. Console tourney's over there. There's a theater over here, and then in the sort of L-shaped back corner of the sixth floor is Expo Hall space, a lot more booths, and we'll go over that way, see that, and then Diversity Lounge over there, we'll go there as well. The theater up here is Chicken. Now, does anyone know why it's called Chicken?
Did it start with a C?
Yes. So it starts with a C. This is the convention center. All the theaters in this building start with a C. It flies. It's up on a higher floor. Right? So.
For a given value of flying.
For a given value of
flying. It'll fly.
It has wings at least. I don't know. The other theater in this building is Cerberus Theater, which is down on the third floor. Doesn't fly down lower. So the theaters, anyone know where Wyvern Theater is?
Weston!
Right? And is it on the ground floor?
No!
No, because it flies, it's up high. So anyone asks you where a theater is, sort of intuit based on the name, you don't necessarily look at the guy. So helpful, helpful. I felt like genius when we figured that out. Yeah!
That was a small study.
There wasn't always probably three. All right, so we're gonna sort of walk through the CFP area, and we'll end up over here and hit that one.
Adventure.
Hat.
Apparently, you need a burger hat.
Right. Each of us wears
six.
Anyway, so CFP, headquarters. This is also the hiding place of Kenneth, who's over there.
Yay! Hi, Kenneth! Kenneth!
Oh, and there's everyone. That's LA with the glasses. He's a PAX lieutenant, which is sort of a high veteran troubleshooting person. So if you see her and she asks you to do something, you should probably do it. She probably won't, but if she asks you, it's probably something important and something's blown up.
Please do it.
Otherwise, she probably won't. All right. This is sort of the back end of the expo hall here. We're going to go around the outside, though, for the crew. And then we're gonna head towards Diversity Lounge. So
this way. Accessible elevators.
Elevator.
Well, don't do it in excess. Just access.
But if you listen to access, while we do it.
He's asking important questions.
It's a hard-hitting journalist.
Back of the fourth floor. We walk across Skybridge and keep going. Once you hit the wall, even before you say something.
Oh, before I hit the wall?
Yeah.
Make up your mind.
If, once you hit the wall, you will have entered it. You will enter it before then.
That's right.
I keep forgetting that.
I used to say 5 years old, so 5 years ago, I spent like 2,000.
Alright, so this is Diversity Lounge, where there are all kinds of fabulous booths, with all kinds of fabulous things, run by all kinds of fabulous people. Amazing people. This is the other side of the 6th floor expo hall, more booths, fabulous people. There are a set of elevators over on this side, and a set of elevators over on that side. Oh, gender neutral bathrooms are those ones. So there's other ones also?
No, I think it's just this one.
Just
this
one? Yep. Okay. So we keep the last 6th floor.
Oh, yeah.
Behind the awesome crew.
Behind the awesome crew. Any other questions about sixth floor before we go down?
Where's the first aid that's up here?
First aid that's up here is, it's kind of hidden, it's in a back hallway. As we were facing Bandland, it's to your right, but it's in a back hallway, so you can't really, it's not like public facing as much as the other one, so. Other questions about sixth floor before we go down? Or anything else? All right, we're gonna take escalators down.
Escalators.
Escalators.
Escalators. Escalators.
Growing.
We are.
Yeah. Catamari.
Oh, that's going on.
Fine. When we leave the building, we'll drop a bunch of people on chairs. Alright, so we've done a little loop so far. We are not done. This is another main entrance to the Expo Hall. Behind us in room 41 is Expo HQ. So that's like central Expo knowledge base. If you're ever sent to go to Expo or you need someone in Expo, whatever, that's the place to go. There's will always be someone in there at least who is sort of one of the Expo manager type people. And they will be able to help you. All right, we're going to go that way, down, around. Carry it forward.
Yeah, those are the oldest ones. I think from launch, like 6 months into like the first
100%. All right. So, this is the North Lobby, used to be called, now called the Skybridge Lobby. Another entrance to Expo. This is also the area where the media and medical passes will get early access to Expo on Friday morning, tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. So this is the spot. If anyone asks you, at the medical badge or media, where am I supposed to go? It's North Lobby, Skybridge Lobby. This is where they go. There's several booths up here, exhibitors. The exhibitor registration is there currently, but it's going to be torn down shortly and will no longer exist once the show starts.
So, Bandland is
now all right, we're going to go down. One floor below us is Cerberus. I'm not going to stop, but we're going to see. That'll be Cerberus. We're going to go through the handheld lounge, which we'll probably stop at. And, yeah. So going down the escalator.
Yeah.
You'll get some breath.
Heavy arcade expo attendant. So I said, flies out.
It just turns out that's your home. It's like, there's a huge
problem. No popping.
Do not flop.
Popping
means popping. It is very sad.
Oh, flopping.
Do not flop.
There's one year with me. Popping
means popping.
Rest.
But if you already dropped, how do you want to kill you?
All right. This is part of Handheld. Handheld headquarters right there behind us. Behind you, in front of me. Handheld lounge is this part and the part above us. We're on the second floor. Over that direction in the theater is the Witcher 3 lounge. No, that's over there. I don't know what that is.
Witcher 3 is by Juicy.
Yeah, that's by Juicy. I don't know what that is. What was it?
Do you not know where Witcher is?
No, I know where Witcher is.
Okay.
I figured that part out. I don't know what that one is. I forgot. It's in the guidebook. Anyone know?
What
that theater is there.
That's
the
BioWare stuff, isn't it?
Yeah, BioWare base. Thank you. Cerberus is one up.
Cerberus is
on
floor 3.
I'm totally
good.
Cerberus is on 2. Anyway, they're both over there. One's on 2, one's on 3.
This is a great tour.
10 out of 10. All the PAXes he's lent in my brain. Like, it's, I don't know. Something's over there. Usually there's a theater on one or the other.
There'll be a sign.
There'll be a sign. You've got guidebooks. Oh, right. Everyone should have guidebook app or the PAX app. Same thing.
Mine was having a spaz attack earlier.
Try re-downloading it sometimes. Do you have an Android?
I think the update.
Yeah. Yeah. Try killing it and re-downloading
it. I did. It was still spazzing.
Try the regular guidebook app. Oh. If it, try the regular guidebook app and download the PAX set from within that, rather than just the PAX app. Sometimes that works better. Yeah. So, but yeah, that's in your smartphone or carry around a paper program. They're both legit. Can be super useful during the weekend. Programs are available at the info booth if you'd like, or there are many other places as well. What else? In this spot. Other questions thus far? We haven't done any trivia yet, really. Do trivia.
Spider-Man or Batman?
No, tax trivia. Okay, so you can raise your hand. There's no prizes though. Sorry. Where is Lost and Found? You can't raise your hand.
You just shouted it out.
Lost and Found. Yes. Yeah, it's in the info booth. These trivias, not all of my questions will be things that I have talked about. Some of them will simulate the seemingly odd and weird questions that you will get from attendees. Mm-hmm. So be fair. They're not going to be fair. They're not going to be fair. Anyway. Should be more water. Here we go. Is a good one. I fell and cut my finger. Do you have a Band-Aid?
No.
Yes. What would you do?
What if you didn't?
Point them towards the first aid station.
Yes. We don't want to give them Band-Aids because there's a lot of liability stuff there that potentially could be a thing. So. Hey.
So don't give them
Band-Aid. Point them towards the first aid station or leave them there. Or if it's serious, call the medics to you. But yeah, don't give them a Band-Aid. There is also, we're going to kind of pass it on the way out, but if you go down those waterfall escalators to the street, one block to your right on the corner is a convenience store. People can buy things if they would like, super convenient. But yeah, please don't give them a Band-Aid. They're just liability stuff. You're all technically employees for this weekend, and so that puts Penny Arcade at risk.
Your first entry, I think.
If they just need a Band-Aid, just
then they're hiring you for the purpose, and that makes them liable.
I see.
Yeah.
They
have. They're like, I think there are 6 paramedics on site at any particular time in 3 different locations, so they can get there very quickly. Yes.
Where do all lost kids go to?
Lost kids. Excellent question. Lost kids or parents go to Lost and Found. Okay. Coordinate them to Lost and Found. A team boo-boo.
If they are lost, go to Lost and Found.
Yes, I mean we just need a central place where we can bring both the parent and the kids, and that is the spot. So security will be, if there are any lost kids or parents with lost kids.
Kids are not lost, I know exactly.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Oftentimes it is. It's like the parent is freaking out because the kid is lost and the kid's sitting in Council Attorney playing Smash Brothers or something. It's fine. Anyway, but our security people with the TRs will handle that kind of stuff. But the central spot to bring them is Lost and Found info booth. So, yes, that's an excellent question.
There's a question over there.
Oh, yeah.
Is there a protocol for
that? If it what is called?
Code Adam. Code Adam is a lost kid.
Or
is that just security deals with it?
Let the security deal with it, yeah. I have a hard time thinking of a case where we would try to mobilize everyone to deal with that.
In the past, we've done Twitter. In the past, we've heard, like, if we're looking for a kid, he's autistic, he looks like this, that kind of stuff.
I mean, usually there's, between the security and the lieutenants and stuff, there's enough people that can look around that we wouldn't worry about trying to Twitter it. It could happen, you know, but that's, the Enforcement News Twitter on your phone so you can get announcements during the weekend is super useful, because there are sometimes things that we need to get information out to you, and that is the only way that we can do it during the weekend, so, yeah.
Does the Lost and Found also, is it also federal at all?
Yes, yeah. So all the off-site locations will centralize. I mean, sometimes it'll take a while for staff to get there.
So a lost kid would have to walk.
I mean, if they were, they would probably play that by ear. Like, if they were at Benaroya and they lost their parent at Benaroya, they would probably look there first. But if they couldn't find them in a reasonable amount of time, they would centralize them there. Yeah.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Once the event starts, I have horrible reception service in here.
Yes.
Yep.
What do we do in that case? Special Wi-Fi?
No.
There is not.
Turn
off LTE.
Yeah, I mean, going down to like the 3G or whatever is probably your best bet. Just try different.
Turn off LTE.
Try different things. Not everyone necessarily has to have announcements set up. As long as you're going to be in groups, so as long as someone gets it, and usually announcements are not like, it doesn't need to be this minute. Like, if you get it in the next half hour, you're good, and usually you'll get, they'll come through eventually.
And guidebook doesn't require Wi-Fi, right?
What is it?
No.
Guidebook. No.
Right.
It should be. Guidebooks should be all cash, so you should be good. Other questions? Good questions. Good questions.
It was a weird question. Really weird.
A really weird one?
Yeah.
Here's a bit of a trick question. Where is the free play?
Which one?
Yes, exactly. Where is the tabletop free play? We haven't even been there yet.
Second floor?
Here and in the Hall of Eight.
Yeah, it's
everywhere.
Well, we haven't been there yet, but it's second floor here. There is some space on the third floor, and the Hall of Eight Hotel also has some free play tabletop. And just any place that they can find a table.
I heard swag
line. Swag bags are this year at the Westin Hotel. So it's where Dev was. It's two giant circular tower building. It's about three blocks that way and about three blocks to the right.
Starts at 10 a.m. tomorrow.
Yeah, it starts at 10 a.m. tomorrow. So
sometimes when there's a corn cob.
So 10 a.m. to
till
6, I think it said.
No, it's probably show close. So midnight, probably 11 or so. Okay, important thing.
Do you know where all the queuing pens are?
What?
Where all the queuing pens are? Queuing pens.
Yeah.
I know that the freeway park is one.
Yeah. The rest of the queuing pens for the morning is. Your best bet is just to follow the guy, the crowds, and the guide. So there will be a ton, like literally 60 or 70 convention center staff that will be guiding people to wherever the current pen is. So, just tell them to come to the. If anyone's asking where should I go in the morning, they come to the entrance. This 7th and Pike, 6th and Pike.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main entrance, and they'll be guided to whatever the current queuing area is from there. I didn't talk about, there is a nursing room, in case you get the question. Tell them to go to info booth, and then they have the key, and they can guide from there, if anyone needs that.
AFK room, just new.
Yeah, AFK room, we're going to sort of go by it. It's 309, so it's one floor up, over in these, next to the waterfall escalators over there. We're going to walk by it. All right, so what are we doing next? Next, we go this way. All right. Carry on! Alright, you guys want to scoot that way a little bit so that people there can get in there?
And kind of squish in.
Yeah, leave a walking
path. Make friends!
Time to huddle.
How close are we talking?
Nah, you're fine. We're not theater sort of levels queuing yet. So. All right, so we passed 204 right down there. That's Tabletop HQ. You can borrow board games there. Anyone has any sort of questions about what is going on in various board game areas, send them there, 204. Up there is 309. That's the Take This AFK Lounge. You've all read about that, right? Did you sign the thing that says you read about it?
Mm-hmm.
I don't even have to explain it. Excellent. If you didn't read about it, go back and read your thing that you signed. It is important. It literally can save lives, that room. So please be aware of it and send people to the area. Tell me about it at least. What else? Juicy Cafe is over there. On the left in the little thing. By the Witcher Lounge.
Hey!
I know everybody. Juicy Cafe is important because Robert Koo likes them, and he likes you. And so he has set up a tab in there so that during show days, if you would go in there, you will get, from a special menu, one meal item a day. Gratis. Mm-hmm. On Robert.
And drink. So,
and yeah, drink. And I think it's a meal and a drink, yeah. So make use of that. Feel free. They have excellent food. It is good. All right, we are going to go down the escalators, out onto the street, and then we'll talk about things that we can see from there. All right?
Cars. Buildings.
Road.
Alright, so, like I said, this is the Annex, zero level.
Guys, excuse me. They are filming live.
Okay, thank you. Alright, like, let's whack aside.
Who's in charge here?
Nobody really.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, I didn't realize.
Thanks, yeah, we have a live event going on right now. We're streaming, so.
Yeah, outside, guys. We're right outside.
Great.
No, too bad. No.
That's fine. It's good. So this is the Hyatt. This is all the stuff for us. The Hyatt is Wyvern, Hydra, Reg, Gigantic Theater, Media Rooms back on the right. Any questions about Hyatt?
Where is handicapped access to Reg?
It's behind us here. There's a lift.
Okay.
But you have to go to the front desk.
Yeah, talk to one of the hotel folks, okay. And they will give you a ride at, on the lift.
That was not the best planning part on us, but we'll make do.
Worked fairly decently.
So every morning from, I think they said 8 to noon, at the registration desk on Convention Place, outside the Convention Center, but like underneath where it was last year, we will have Reg as well. So, and then we'll have medical badges and all the badges except for media and enforcers, they will have there. So, as a sort of auxiliary Reg.
So about the tomorrow morning enforcers.
Yes.
I mean, obviously everyone here has their enforcer badge already, but. For people who need registration badges.
If you know someone or you meet someone who needs their badge tomorrow morning and cannot get it today, they need to come here, the Hyatt Reg, to get their badge until noon, until 10, and then we will cycle back over to input. So the thing is, you can't get into the convention center. It'll be difficult to get into the convention center without a badge because we'll be sending people to all the queue areas. So we'll be closing things off. If you don't already have your badge, you won't be able to get in there. So, you get your badge. So anyway, yes. If you don't have a badge, if someone doesn't have a badge and needs it tomorrow morning before 10, send them here. If they have a mid-shift, they can go to info after 10 and be fine. Okay, so. Yes, good question. Other questions? Annex that we didn't get to see really. Alright, let's go to the Sheraton. Yeah.
past it. But, so.
Escalator of Shame.
That's a surprise.
Oh, that's cool. That is so cool.
There's your badges ballad.
Yeah. All right, so the Sheraton, second floor. So, like, Sasquatch would be on this floor. Sphinx flies, it would be one floor up. Right now, there is a fabulous community event happening where they just are playing board games. Organize their own little thing. It is not an official PAX thing, it's just their own little thing. There's also donations to Picky Brigade and stuff like that. Pre-PAX board game night, happening many years. Sheraton. Also, so down on the lobby is Merch Light. We talked about it has polygon pins, which we're probably going to ask about, but otherwise has all the same stuff as main merch. What else? There's some various other things in here. There's another HTC Steam VR demo thing.
Yeah, right over there.
Is it here? Okay.
There's signs at least.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Right. And there's a couple other vendor exhibitors that have their own room up here on these two floors. In your guidebook, you can find them. What else? Line Entertainment headquarters is here, probably in one of these rooms. What else? Questions?
This one's pretty straightforward.
Other questions about other things we've seen? All right, we're gonna go back downstairs, out through the main lobby door, and then left towards Union. So.
All right.
Because we're all supposed to be that meeting.
That's
like,
yeah,
what are you?
You're on my
watch. I'm probably going to sleep in this week. I'm on my watch. More questions? Yeah.
I heard there would be prizes.
I know. All right, we're missing four.
You heard incorrectly.
Previous tours have had prizes. You took. You waited too long to become an enforcer. I apologize. There might be that. Consensual.
Yeah. I heard there would be cake.
That's what I was going for.
Where is cake?
The cake was a lie.
They're actually.
No. Somebody, there is a cake.
Yeah, there's
a cake.
Where is cake?
I don't know where. Are you going to place now? Other questions.
I believe you have my
table. I don't think I have any tables. All right, carry on, go forth. 6 o'clock, Cerberus.
Where is that?
Cerberus, third floor. Yeah. North, Skybridge Lobby.
Okay, Cerberus.
Me and Alex have entered the building.
After the night.
Yep.